everybody. Fran in the lab, blah, blah, blah. Just kind of chilling. I wanted to make a little video about something that's been on my mind recently. It's a philosophical issue. It's also a scientific issue, and I think it's worth talking about. And that is the scientific and cultural and societal implications of meaning. Because I've written about this. I haven't talked about it on my channel, but I've written about it in essays and such in the past that, in my view, I have always maintained that meaning is not intrinsic, that there is no inherent meaning in anything, that, you know, existence, life on our planet, the things that we do, the things that we don't do, the acts of humans and the consequences therein, that there's really no meaning in anything, that life itself is meaningless and the things we do are meaningless. There's no value to anything, no purpose. That the only meaning to anything is the meaning that we, as individuals and as a society, put into it. So life can have value if we value it, and people can have value if we value them, and ideas can have value if we value them, and life can be worthwhile if we think of it as being worthwhile, but it's not a given. And the implications for that are, okay, so if everything is intrinsically meaningless, then, you know, it's basically a free-for-all, which it is, which is why as societies we have, you know, laws and norms and societal expectations, these things that are supposed to try and rein in our behaviors and the way that we think, and we are raised in a certain way to try to comply to norms and expectations so that we don't, you know, act too far outside of a very certain established list of behaviors and expectations. So that's one end of it. But the other side of it is that because there is no intrinsic meaning in anything, that meaning and value and significance and purpose can be denied to certain things or certain people or certain ways of thinking by choice. And that has led to all of the bad things about us as a species, because we have the ability to selectively put meaning and purpose and value into certain things and people and ideas and ways of living, and then just as easily we can erase or deny that meaning or value to other people, things, and ways of thinking. And it is the completely subjective nature of meaning that we end up in a position where we are as a world, where we've always been. It's always been this way with people. And it is really the core of all of our problems. And the thing, it's funny because the solutions to our biggest problems are so simple. We just don't want to do them. You know, the very simple solution to our problems as a species is that all we'd have to do is be decent to one another, to give each other the benefit of the doubt, common courtesy, respect. That's it. You know, if we could do that, we wouldn't be terrible to one another. We wouldn't kill each other. You know, if we could value each other equally, we wouldn't go to war. We wouldn't kill each other. We wouldn't have the condition of our species. It's just that simple. It's the one thing that people in generally just won't do. And we just won't do it, you know. It's been written about in so many stories, fictitious stories, that if only some great threat could come from the cosmos in the form of an attacking army of predatory aliens or a big meteor coming, that we'd have to rally everyone together to, you know, save the species. If some huge overwhelming threat were to come upon us, that we would all come together We would put apart our differences, we would see the commonality, and we would struggle for the species. And yet, you know, we have those challenges right now. You know, climate change, nuclear war, pandemics. These are all things that are bigger than any one of us, bigger than any one nation, and they don't bring us together, they just make us fight more. It seems that with every threat, we just sort of divide ourselves more, factionalize ourselves more. So the solutions are very simple if we want to do them. I don't know. We are a very strange species. Very strange species indeed. But meaning? I can't give that to you. That's something that only you can apply to the things you hold dear, as can I. But I think that the more meaning that we can put to each other, the better we will be as a species. And I know that to be a fact. I'm Fran. I'll be back here in the lab doing something lab related, later on. But in the meantime, be decent to one another. And be adequate to yourself. It's good advice. All right. Bye! In the lab. That's where I work. Berserk. In my lab, it's where I work. At the bench again.